Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and this past week Apple released different updates where many people were asking me, why don't I see it yet, or it's not really out, or what's the problem, or why isn't the update available for me? And so I wanted to talk a little bit about this since this is a little bit of a change for Apple. Now, this past week, Apple released iOS 15.2 Beta 3. I talked about some new features in that. They also released iOS 15.1.1 to address specific features and watchOS 8.1.1. Now, before we talk about what specifically they updated here and what to expect in the future, there's a Discord server where many people have been talking about this on the zollotech community. So if you want to check that out, I've linked it in the description. You can check it out just by going there to zollotech. Again, there's actually a link in the description so you can check it out. People are talking about everything from Android to iOS and more. So if you want to discuss this further after the video, be sure to check that out. Also, on the weekend, I normally do an iOS follow-up, and there's currently a community poll on YouTube. If you go to the community tab on my channel, you can see there's 6,000 votes currently where I'm asking about iOS 15.1.1 and iOS 15.2 Beta 3. So asking which version you're on, how it's been for you, and also maybe comment with your experience and how it's going. So I use that information to give you the most comprehensive, in-depth look at iOS every weekend to see if it's something you should update to or how it's going in general. Now, as far as this past week, like I said, Apple released three different versions, and the first one was a beta. That was a pretty typical release. And so that came out with some features and some changes. That's a future release, and it came out to all iOS 15 devices if you're a developer or a public beta tester. After that, the next day or so, they released iOS 15.1.1. This is a little bit of a departure. A week or so ago, Apple released tvOS 15.1.1 and HomePodOS 15.1.1. They separated out those devices, and then a while later, or a week or more later, they released iOS 15.1.1. We haven't seen this in quite some time. And the reason I say that is because it was only available for some devices. As you can see here, it says iOS 15.1.1 improves call drop performance on iPhone 12 and iPhone 13 models. That means it's specific to devices and not available for all the devices. So if you went to check for it on an iPhone 7 or an iPhone XR, it wasn't there, and it's still not there. So now we have split versions between different devices. If you have a XR or an iPhone 7, you have iOS 15.1 is the most recent. The same is true with iPad. And all iPads only have iPadOS 15.1. However, if you have an iPhone 13, 13 mini, 13 Pro, or 13 Pro Max, or iPhone 12, 12 mini, 12 Pro, or 12 Pro Max, you'll have this update to fix call drop performance. Now, the only thing specific on these newer devices, the 12 series and 13, is Qualcomm modems. So there must have been a major issue there. However, Apple rarely releases the update to just a few devices, or eight in this case, where they're only available to some devices and not all devices that support iOS 15 or earlier versions. Last year, we had something specific for iOS 14, but they don't do this that often. Now, they could be following up with things they need to get done before the holiday this time around, and that may be why they did that, but this is a little bit unprecedented because they didn't just do that with iOS, but they also did that with watchOS. So Apple released watchOS 8.1.1, and this is even more specific. They released it for the Series 7, and you can see here it says it fixes an issue where Apple Watch Series 7 may not charge as expected for some users, and then also there's some security website or security content on their website, and we'll check that out in a moment. But it fixes specific issues for a Series 7, but not just all Series 7, one model of Series 7. Now, on the security website from Apple, if we scroll down, you can see the updates, and it says watchOS 8.1.1. It's available for the Apple Watch Series 7 GPS plus cellular, not just the one with Wi-Fi. So if you have a cellular plus GPS model, then you'll have 8.1.1. If you don't, you won't have it. Again, below that, you can see iOS 15.1.1 with iPhone 12 and later. This is something we haven't really seen separating across devices like this, and so only for specific models. And this is something I'm really not a fan of because now we have multiple versions across multiple devices and even multiple versions across multiple series of devices. So I really hope they go back to the normal way of doing things as far as releasing them all at once. But these seem to be either specific enough that they needed to fix this, maybe a security update. And it does say this update has no public published CVE entries for security, but that doesn't mean they didn't update something. They felt it necessary to publish it here at least. So there could be security updates they just don't want us to know about. So it's possible they're there. Maybe there's nothing, but it's odd to see them push all of these out. So if you have an iPhone that's not a Series 12 or Series 13, that's why you don't have that update. The same is true with Apple Watch. Again, hopefully they change this in the future. And they've even done something stranger with Apple Watch, where they completely skipped over watchOS 8.2 for some reason, and we have watchOS 8.3 betas available right now. So they completely skipped over. We have watchOS 8.1.1, no watchOS 8.2, and just straight to watchOS 8.3. And if you're not someone that follows this stuff every day or sort of lives and breathes updates, it can be very confusing. And Apple is all about simplicity. So I really hope this is just them catching up by the end of the year, where they're getting things all set before the holiday, and then we'll get back to normal. If not, it's going to be even more difficult for the consumer to know what's going on as far as public updates and why their update is different than someone else, why they have 8.1.1, but someone with a Series 4 doesn't. And that's just a bit confusing. And then people start to feel left out as well. So it's not great for the consumer experience or the customer experience. And I hope they really fix this. Now, with Apple releasing 15.2, I really would expect them to release that probably within a couple weeks before their holiday break in December. Typically the last few weeks in December, they take a break around Christmas time and different holidays so that people can have some time off and not worry about the updates. They generally put a halt on them usually around the week of Christmas, and it sort of slows down. We get a little bit of a break from updates, but they typically release an update before that time. So I would expect iOS 15.2 sometime before Christmas at this point, or before the holiday break for Apple. Also, maybe a beta next week, and then maybe a week after with a release candidate soon, and then the final, like I said. So those things make a lot of sense to me. However, we just don't know at this point, as Apple is really randomly releasing things. For all we know, we could see iOS 15.1.1 released to other devices next week. So I doubt it at this point, but it's very possible. The other day, Apple did something we didn't really expect. And again, this goes along with their updates. Things seem to be changing a little bit. And Apple announced a self-service repair service for those who are comfortable changing the parts on their iPhone. So it says starting with iPhone 12 and 13, they'll make parts, tools, and manuals available to individual customers. And quite a few of you have asked me to comment on this. And so I'm really grateful they're going to do this, but I'm not really sure how much they're going to allow, whether it's just batteries and displays, or are they going to make available maybe speakers and ports and everything else that's possibly needed to repair your phone properly. So I think this would be great if it's as easy to do as maybe walking into an Apple store saying, I need a new display. It's out of warranty. I would like the display and the manual and all the parts and even the software or calibration tools needed for this to sort of self-calibrate. And so those things sound great to me. It's just, I'm a little bit concerned that it won't be everything. So maybe you need more than a battery. Maybe you need the buttons for the volume buttons or the silent switch or something else that's broken. If all of those things are available, I think that's a great step in the right direction. It's definitely something that many of us never thought would happen. So hopefully they make this available not only for iPhones, but for Mac and everything more, for those that really need to repair their own devices, whether that be an old iPad or something else. We can get official parts that should work as expected, as long as we can repair them. It can be a bit tricky to repair certain things. I've tried to repair screens in the past with the iPhone 4. That was harder than currently, but repairing screens these days is not too difficult if you're fairly understanding of how things work and things are assembled. So if you typically work on your own car, you could probably work on this, although parts are much, much smaller. So I'm glad to see them do this if you have the ability to. But replacing a battery on your own, maybe getting it for a reasonable cost and replacing it, would be a great step in the right direction. And hopefully we can order those parts as well. So we'll have to wait and see if Apple allows that. But I really am glad to see them do something like this. This is something a lot of people, including myself, have wanted for a long, long time. And so the current update state, I don't think is going to be the future going forward in 2022, when we get to iOS 16 and beyond. But I do think that we're going to see some different different changes, hopefully some much better stability and more. And I plan to have that follow-up probably tomorrow or Sunday with the follow-up about all of the current updates with iOS 15.1.1, 15.2 beta 3, and how it's going based on my experience and your experience. So in the future, like I said, I really hope iOS 16 becomes much more stable and maybe even brings an update. But as we get closer to seeing that next June, then we'll know more about it. But at this point, I'm just waiting for the updates to be very stable and to make the iPhone the best it can be. But let me know your thoughts on the current way Apple is updating phones in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.